Hi, Lou. Bye, Lou. It's good that I hear you're retiring, and I don't know if you're going to stay in the area, but anyway, you were a real sweet guy, and hopefully everything will work out and you'll have a good time. Bye.
Hi, Lou. Congratulations on your retiring. We're really going to miss you. I really enjoyed working with you, and you're a great person, and I wish you a wonderful life and a wonderful retirement, and I hope you have everything going your way. And keep in touch. I almost said don't keep in touch. Keep in touch. Thank you.
Goodbye, Lou. It was nice knowing you. I hope you come to visit us.
Bye.
Bye, Lou. I hope you have a great future, and it's been really nice to know you.
Hi, Lou. I can't do a thing with my hair. But anyway, it was nice knowing you, although we didn't get a chance to get to know each other really well. I wish you a lot of luck in your next endeavors, and come and visit us soon, okay? Bye.
Lou, we're really going to miss you. Good luck in everything that you do, and enjoy retirement. I envy you.
Bye. Lou, I'm going to miss you so much. I've always enjoyed our conversations and seeing you here every day, but I wish you the best in your retirement. Have a wonderful one. Bye.
Bye, Lou. Enjoy your retirement.
Bye, Lou. It was great working with you. I hope you have a great time. Bye-bye.
Bye, Lou. It was nice working with you, even though I didn't get to work that closely with you. Still fun guy. So good luck. Have fun. I wish I was retired, too. Bye.
Lou, I am going to miss you. Best wishes to you, but I know I'll see you around in the neighborhood. See ya. Bye.
Congratulations on your retirement. I hope you enjoy it.
Well, congratulations, Lou, on your retirement. Wish you the best of luck. Thank you.
Lou, congratulations on your retirement, and wishing you the best of luck.
Goodbye.
Bye, Lou. Happy retirement. Hope to see you around.
Let me take a look
fun.
At your
Bye.
Goodbye, Lou Alexander. We're sorry that you're leaving, and I appreciate everything that you've done for me, but I wish you could stick around, but I know you're going to enjoy your retirement. Adios.
Okay, bye, Lou. Enjoy your retirement.
Lou. Hey, Lou. We're really going to miss you. I hope you enjoy your days of solitude with all your hummingbirds. I'll miss seeing you and talking to you about all that, so take care. Bye.
I just wanted to say congratulations. I hope you have a wonderful time being yourself, and I just want to say thanks for everything. Okay.
Best of luck. Hope you have a great retirement. Learned a lot working with you. Take care.
Great retirement. It's been a pleasure working with you. Have fun. See you.
Hi, Lou. I just found out you're going to be retiring. You're so lucky. I'm sorry that you're going to be leaving us, but I'm happy for you, and I hope everything works out in your future. Bye.
Lou, congratulations. I can't believe you're leaving us with this mess. Anyway, good luck to you. Keep in touch, and we'll miss you. Bye.
This is Demetra. I do have a Starbucks, but I do go to pizza a lot. Maybe I'll see you there sometime. Take care. Wish you well.
Hey, Lou, good luck with your retirement. We'll miss you, the last of the old
crew. Bye.
Goodbye, Lou. I wore this shirt today, especially for this occasion, and even though I didn't know I was going to be taped today, just worked out that way. And maybe I'll run into you on the Los Gatos Creek Trail sometime while you're rollerblading and I'm riding my bicycle. Bye.
Lou, I just want to say it was nice working with you. You've always been fair and honest. You always hear both sides of the story. And if I had a question, you told me the way it really was, without giving any bullshit. Appreciate it and enjoy your retirement. Can't wait to start my own. Bye.
Hi, Lou. It's Gail. We go back a long ways, and I'm going to have to keep this picture now because I'm one of the few left now that you're leaving. There's only a couple of us left. And there you are. And there I am. And I just want to say thanks for being a wonderful boss. And good friend, and I'm gonna miss you, and call me anytime, and give me your phone number, so if I have any Excel questions, I can call you, okay? Mwah. I love you, Lou. Bye-bye.
Hi, Lou. I just wanted to
wish you a happy retirement, and it was a pleasure working with you way back when. Remember when Doris was on medical leave? Anyways, God bless you, and just enjoy yourself. Bye.
Hey, Lou. Glad to see you're able to go. Wish I was going with you, but have a good time, and don't think of us too much. Bye.
Hi, Lou. It's really nice to know you're going to be able to retire, and I hope you enjoy yourself. It's been fun knowing you all these years. Good luck.
Hi, Lou. It's Rita. Just wanted to wish you well in your new venture. We'll miss you, and come back and see us, okay?
Hi, Lou. Just want to wish you a great retirement, and it's been a pleasure working with you all the way from my temp days to the date. And just good luck, and take care.
Hey, Lou, it's been real, or maybe it's been unreal. I don't know, but we've been through a whole lot, and you get to go, and I still get to go through it. So I'm going to miss you. Every time I think about my toolbox and my hammer and some of the other tools, I will think of you. Take care. Love you. Bye.
Well, Lou, I think I said pretty much all I needed to say to you that day I came into your office, so you know how I feel. It's a shame, and we're going to miss you, and wish you the best of luck. You're too young to totally retire. You need to start a new career, hopefully at another newspaper who will benefit from your years of wisdom. So best of luck to you, and see you later.
We're
going to
miss you, Lou. We all wish you well. I hope you come back and visit us every so often. Happy retirement.
Gonna miss you, big guy. You've been a friend to me for a lot of years, and we've been through a lot of shit. But I'm really gonna miss you, but I'll tell you what, I really envy you. I got 3.5 more years to go. Okay? Take care, man. Have a good one.
Lou, good luck in all your endeavors. I want to thank you for the many, many years of nuggets of information you've given us, and especially for seeing to it that I was invited to as many advertiser golf tournaments as possible. I really appreciate that. Thanks a lot. Good luck. Bye.
Goodbye, Lou. This is from Tess, and I believe we've shared many, many years together. I'm still here, and you're not going to be. Good luck to you. Best of everything. Bye.
Good luck in life. Man, good luck in life, Lou. Nice knowing you. If you ever get thrown in jail, I'm calling bad boy bail bonds just for you. Alright, good luck, man. Later.
Hello, it was great working with you and knowing you for all these years. Good luck, and we'll see you soon. Bye.
Hey, Lou, I just want to thank you for all the help that you gave to Nuevo Mundo. We're going to miss you a lot, and we love you. Bye.
Hi, Lou. Just wanted to wish you a happy retirement and best wishes with all your future plans. Thank you for all your help, and it's been nice working with you.
Hey, and guess what? Tomorrow is Lou's last day. Boy, is it going to be great to see him gone. He is such a pink. Hi, Mark. How are you doing? Hi, Lou. We're sure going to miss you. Have a great vacation. This one's for you. Cheers, dude.
I wish you all the best, and it's been wonderful to work with you, so good luck.
Hi, Lou. Everybody's probably going to miss you, but what I like best about you is your sarcastic humor. At least we get along. Bye.
Welcome to the Lou Alexander goodbye party. Lou, step right up here.
Yeah, got up in water.
I've been busy taking pictures.
Okay, so before we get to cut the cake, we have a brief program, starting with me and then Jeff Keel, and then we have two highly distinguished former Mercury News employees who have sent a video of a message that I know you're going to want to hear. And then it would only be fair for us to give you a chance to respond to all the nice things that I'm sure would be said about you.
I have six pages.
So on my behalf, I'll just say, one, thank you for 20 years of marvelous service. I actually knew Lou from afar, from my years in Miami. In Miami, I was forever trying to find a classified director, about every 2 years. And so I'd call Knight Ritter and I'd say, so who do you got that could really help me as a classified director? And they would say, Lou Alexander, but you gotta talk to Jay Harris and all that stuff like that. And I'd call Jay, and Jay would say, oh, I really wish you wouldn't, but okay. And so about every 2 years I'd call, Lou would answer his own phone, and I would say, Lou, it's Joe Natoli, you know, Miami, da 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 da. Lou would go, no, you know, Joe, I think I'll just stay in California for now.
Very accurate.
Isn't that true? Yeah. So we did, Lou and I did that about every other year for about 10 years, I think. So Lou, I was an admirer from afar and have appreciated your knowledge, particularly your institutional knowledge of this place and of our customers and of the newspaper advertising business. You've been a wonderful contributor to the Mercury News. Those of us who have come lately have been fortunate to join a really, really wonderful company that does great things in the community and has a very, very strong business. And I think we all owe a debt of gratitude for the folks who built this place and made it what it is today. And I think Lou Alexander is just a wonderful example of that. So, Lou, amen. Thank you very much.
Brief one, year and a half here, and being out in the community, I mean, it just seems like almost everywhere you go, people are telling you to say hi to Lou. So, clearly Lou's made quite a difference here for the Mercury News and in advertising. And last week we had an outing with some of our customers in Carmel, and so I thought it would be befitting for me to make the announcement and thank Lou for all he's done for the Mercury News over the years and tell our customers a little bit about Lou. And when I pulled some information, it was easy for me to see why I've been able to rely so much on Lou for the institutional knowledge, but also just general business knowledge about this place and how it operates and the newspaper business overall. So I had some information pulled on Lou, some of which I didn't know about, but Lou has done a lot of different things that my guess is would be a surprise to some of you. Some of you probably already know this. And so when I look back over Lou's career, even pre-Mercury News, I mean, Lou was a reporter and a photographer in Greensburg, Indiana, in Louisville, Kentucky. He was an editor and I messed this all this up last week, and I'll probably mess it up again. And Lou will happily help me on some of these names. He was an editor in Monongahela, Pennsylvania. A general manager in Waynesburg, Pennsylvania. An advertising director in Ypsilanti, Michigan.
Near perfect.
An advertising director in Yakima, Washington.
Close enough.
Okay, that's not bad. Aside from all the different roles he's had here at the Mercury News, sales development manager, retail advertising manager, display advertising manager, classified advertising manager, and most recently, advertising operations director. And so once again, I'll just reiterate, in my year and a half here, I've relied heavily on Lou's knowledge and I never had to ask Lou for feedback because, he would never hesitate to come into my office and say, Jeff, let me give you a little bit of feedback. And I always valued and learned from it. And you can't underestimate other people's opinions and observations. So, as Joe did, I'd just like to say that I really appreciate all Lou's done for Knight Ritter over the last 20 or 21 years. but also over the last year and a half since I've been here, just all the help that he's given to me. And so once again, I'd like to say, Lou, thanks for everything. Really appreciate it.
Sure.
And now, Angela Campbell.
Well, we've got friends here from past and present, and we've got a special presentation from some folks in Tampa, Florida.
Oh, Tampa. Who the hell are you in Florida?
Be at this venue because, well, let's just say we've been well coached in our careers by a guy named Lou Alexander. And Greg Aarons and I thought, you know, what better way to talk about great coaching and to thank a great coach than to be in a venue where great coaches have been successful.
Well, I want to tell you it's been a pleasure for me to work with you many years, and best of everything in this new chapter of your life. May God bless this new chapter of your life.
Thank you.
Shall we all pray?
Sacrilegious.
However, I have three vital warnings to the new retiree. As a retiree of 2 years, I feel it is my duty to warn Lou Alexander of three phenomena that could come as an unsettling shock to him without this alert.
I just have to check one thing.
One, very soon, this is, try to be serious now, okay, this is,
as serious as I can be.
I want you to, I really want you to take these in.
I'm listening.
Very soon, a strange woman will be coming into your life. Take it from me. The eerie sensation that you met somewhere before will be eclipsed by the challenges of this new relationship. Who is this woman? Your wife.
Boy's dead over at.
That's right. The new theme song of your life together will be Getting to Know You, Getting to Know All About You. Number two, on a fateful morning, some distance into retirement, you will awake with a start, suddenly realizing that you do not know the previous month's advertising revenue figures. And hating yourself for not caring. Number three, you undoubtedly have heard about the identity crisis that afflicts men when they retire. The theory holds that men soon find they have lost their identity and yearn to go back to work. Indeed, a few weeks from now, you will be wondering about identity. The identity of the idiot who originated the male identity crisis theory.
Joe Bosnacker. And by the way, everyone, we have cake, vegetables, soda, and water, so please help yourselves.
I get tired of listening to all these advertising executives. At some point, I have to give you a dose of reality. You know, from us in operations, we had a different relationship with Lou, continue to have a different relationship with Lou. I myself got here about 4 years ago and was almost immediately thrown into a project along with Lou Alexander that, I got to hand it to you, the 50-inch paper with change was something that touched every division of the company. But if it were not for Lou and some of the mentoring and feedback that he provided myself and that team, you probably would not have been as successful in that cutdown. That was kind of the opening of the door for a relationship that I had with Lou, and to this day I continually go to Lou for feedback. He's been somewhat of a mentor and has definitely provided information to me and some guidance that I think has affected the operations and production divisions of this company. So for that, we thank Lou. He'll definitely be sorely missed in operations.
Thank you.
Mike Lynch.
And I think I'm the guy that he was afraid.
You might want to censor some of the names. Okay?
All right, I'll censor some of the names. This is the first time I've been asked to come back here.
I know. Since 1990.
I know. Lou and I go back a very long time. And when he leaves, certainly a great amount of history leaves this San Jose Mercury News, and a great deal of hard work But I remember not just the hard work, but some of the more humorous things about Lou Alexander. And for all of you who don't know this, you should never ask a question if you don't want the real answer from Lou Alexander. So I'm going to tell you a story in which really... which somebody said they bet I wouldn't tell, but I will. I'll leave the names out, but there was a former employee who used to be here, a rather tall woman.
Big Bird!
who once upon a time in an episode in the human resources department made the mistake of accusing Lou of maybe doing something that was dishonest. And for anybody who knows Lou, nothing could be farther from the truth. So Lou's response was almost predictable. But Lou looked her in the eye and said, "You know, unnamed Big Bird, if I didn't think there was a serious chance I would lose, I would take you outside and kick your butt right now."
This, by the way, is Mike Lynch, who's now the VP, Senior VP Advertising, maybe Executive VP Advertising, for all I know, at A&G. He's got it basically right. It was actually in the office that Keogh's now in. John Hammond was there. There was another vice president there and another manager. And I said, "I don't care if you're a girl. I don't care if you're younger than me. I don't care if you've got longer than reach than me. I want to kick your ass if you don't take it back right now."
None of you would be here today if it weren't for me.
That's right.
I hired Lou 20 years ago.
21, technically.
21 years ago. I've been retired myself for 13 years, and I've never regretted having Lou on board. He was a guy that would do most anything that you wanted without complaining about it. A lot of the jobs I didn't want to do, I gave to Lou for his experience. I do remember, he had some quirky habits occasionally. I do remember one time he said, "You know, Bob, you're lucky to have me." I said, "Why is that?" He said, "Well, I know how to handle women and you don't." "Why, is that true?" But Lou's been a great credit to the Mercury News, and I've always been proud that I am.
Thank you.
I need the help of Nikki for the next part. Yep. It's up here, Nikki, on the table.
She's one. Come up there with
her. We had a collection, and there's a surprise here from everybody.
Okay. We got you a box.
You'll have to set it down.
Yeah, it has some heft here. My wife is not here, so I will save the ribbon, but not the paper. I noticed y'all knew who I meant when I said Big Bird, by the way. Or at least some of the longer-term employees did. You know, the polite thing to do is open the cards first, but the hell with polite. Prize customers. You know, one of the special joys will no longer be able to see the damn building on. Wow. This is magnificent. My home laptop is a NEC Versa 2200C.
A new one.
Hey Lou, I want you to know we loaded MacDiv on that for you.
Don't drop. Yeah, actually, I just want to see it open. You can see that I'm sort of stammering here.
Wow.
This is really magnificent, my God.
Oh. Hey,
this is really wonderful. Thank you all very much. Go
call if anybody else wants to talk, because I got 6 pages. I
just want to say real quick.
Good, Rob McGurvey's going to talk. Rob McGurvey can't clear his throat in 20 minutes.
All I want to say was I was here the day that Bob Williams had, really great to see Bob Williams.
Amen.
It's really great to see Mike. It's great to see Vi Burkin.
Amen.
And all these folks, Pat Murphy, and
you
these
know
people
real
just
quick.
Working, you know, anyway, it was just, it's really something. It's really nice. But Lou, you were here today. I mean, I was here when you came in, got to meet you. I was reporting to you for the entire decade of the 80s and part of the 90s, and you were enormously helpful on some really important projects. I really appreciate it. And you were always a big supporter to hang in there with us all these years. I just wanted to thank you for that.
Okay, I actually do have written notes because I was afraid I'd forget something or someone. And I'm going to do something that might be a little odd to start out with. I want to ask that we take a moment here to remember Joe Tovar. Joe was an old-timer when I got here. He was one of the kids in dispatch, although I think he was the exact same age I was when I got here, and I didn't think of myself as a kid. And he was the absolute star on our old proof desk. Customers would wait on hold forever until Joe was available to take their proof corrections. My wife in the early 80s was the entire ad department in a long-gone appliance store called McPhail's, and when I told her last night about Joe, she was so upset, remembering him all these years later. Retailers who would visit the building would allow us to drag them off to meet the publisher, but they really wanted to meet Joe. They demanded to meet Joe. So for just a moment now, just say a prayer for Joe or remember him fondly or do whatever else you think would be appropriate to celebrate his too short life, as far as I possibly could have. Let me start out by thanking all of you for coming out here today on a warm afternoon. The weather we have here is one of the reasons that I am retiring. I want to be able to enjoy days with highs in the mid-80s, light winds, and low humidity. I want to be able to drive around in my Impala that's sitting over here, my 62 Super Sport, in my red hat looking very cool. I want to thank all of you who have spoken this afternoon. I am overwhelmed by the warm sentiments. I truly, truly am. I knew I would be emotional, but this is more than I had expected. Thank you for the incredible gift and some other gifts that people have dropped off. I will remember all of you very fondly when I use them. Thanks to the dozens of people who have stopped me in my hallway or come by my office to say goodbye, wish me well, reminisce for a moment. And then thanks to all the folks who no longer work here who gave up an afternoon while they're retired to come in. I mean, Vi Burke and her husband came down from the mountains. Lynn is here, Bob Williamson, Mike Lynch. It's probably the first time Mike's been, I think, first time you've been back in his building since 1990. That's truly wonderful to see those folks. Okay, in the 21 years I've been here, I've heard a great many retirement speeches. Some have been good and some have been bad. But in every instance, I eventually understood that people were doing the best that they could. So I would ask the same consideration of you. Just remember that I'm doing the best I can. What I thought I'd do here this afternoon is answer some of the questions people have asked me in the recent weeks as I got closer to retirement so I can quit answering them 400 times. People have asked me what I will miss about the Mercury News. I will miss the unlimited, always-on, high-speed internet access. I use AOL on a dial-up at home, so you can email me at loualex@aol.com. And I'll eagerly respond, but it may be a challenge getting AOL to come up so I can actually send you an email. I will really miss having an ATM machine between my chair and the ice machine. Do not have an ATM in my family room. And actually, I will really miss that ice machine because all of you have ice in the door on your refrigerators and not near as good. It just never works like this wonderful ice dispenser. I will miss the really big, hairy deals. The Loma Prieta earthquake when we delivered a newspaper the next morning that truly brought tears to my eyes.
Wow.
Nice job, Phil. That truly brought tears to my eyes when I went out and saw a complete newspaper with an entire section on that earthquake. I'll miss delivering papers when the carriers were on strike, getting ready for the end of negotiating the union contracts, planning for buyouts. Actually, as I wrote this and thought about it, I will not miss, I will miss the adrenaline rush some of those things gave me. I will not miss those unpleasantries. I will miss being a day-to-day part of an institution that touches the lives of hundreds of thousands of people each day. The work we do here is critical to our readers and our advertisers, and I plead with all of you to bear that in mind each day. Moreover, I will obviously and most deeply miss the people. I've always thought this was an odd thing for retirees to say. Now just think about it. The machines, computers, networks, cars, whatever, almost always do what you want them to, and people sometimes don't. But the chance to spend nearly 21 years with all the fine people here today and all the people who have been here before you has been a priceless gift. Okay, next question. People have asked me what things I am proudest of during my time at the Mercury News. There are dozens of things, but I will mention three. I'm immensely proud of the role I played in the launch of Viet Mercury. We had just about nothing when the publisher of the Mercury News decided he wanted to launch in 5 months. No rates, no salespeople, no customers. And we launched on time with a 168-page first issue that provided the foundation for the profitable newspaper we have today. I am very proud of the part I played in solving a call-abandoned problem that had plagued the Mercury News classified department for decades. When I went into classified in 1995, we sometimes failed to answer as many as 20% of the calls from customers who wanted to place the classified ad. It took us, especially Marcia Sherrill and me, a while to get it fixed, but when we were done, we were answering about 98% of the calls and generating millions of dollars in additional revenue. And I am proud of the people. I am proud of the people I have hired, trained, and mentored. I am grateful for the people who have been patient with me, and made me a better person. Now, people have asked me about my plans for retirement. This one is really simple. My wife and I plan to hang around Santa Clara County for about a year. We want to enjoy the good weather, and we're going to spend that time figuring out what we want to do next, which almost surely means leaving and getting the money out of the house. Okay, finally, people have asked me for some words of wisdom. So I will leave you with two things to think about. I want you all to remember Clara Peller, the Wendy's lady who used to say, "Where's the beef?" in those TV commercials. Here's what I mean by that. Bright ideas and business plans are always a great start. But eventually, those bright ideas and business plans need to produce new readers and or new revenue. Now, the second thing I would ask you to remember is Abbott and Costello. And this is kind of a youngish crowd, so this is a little nervy for me. But I suspect most of you have heard the old Abbott and Costello Who's On First routine. Most of
you? Yeah.
Okay. They're fairly late in that bit. There's a place where Lou Costello says to Bud Abbott, "When they send the paycheck to the first baseman, who gets it, right? If you get the paycheck or insert your job title here, then you really must do that job." All right, that's it, folks. Thanks again for everything. Stay in touch and let's enjoy some cake and cookies, et cetera.
And I'll be following you in about another, maybe 3.5 years. I just want to let you know how wonderful it's been working with you, and you're one of the dying breed. You're one of the last few people left in the company who still care about the people, and we really appreciated that. And like Susie Orman, the financial wizard on TV, says, people first, then money, then things. And I truly believe that's what you feel. You really cared about the people, and we appreciate it. Good luck, and come back and see us again sometime. Bye.
Home of the world champion Tampa Bay Buccaneers. We thought it was appropriate to be at this venue because, well, let's just say we've been well coached in our careers by a guy named Lou Alexander. And Greg Aarons and I thought, you know, what better way to talk about great coaching and to thank a great coach than to be in a venue where great coaches have been successful. So, Lou, it's not funny, but it is a little clever, you have to admit, for us to say thank you very much and congratulations on a well-deserved retirement, and we really look forward to seeing you more, not less. Thanks, Lou.
Lou Alexander's retired. Boy, just like Cliff said, we had to come to a stadium where coaching is done right. And only Lou could do that coaching for us. Well, I just want to wish you well, man. Appreciate all you've done for us.
continue. Best wishes, good hope. Tell your dad we said hello. Take care, Lucy.